Okay, we're officially in week four. I'm currently halfway through a 4.8k alternating every 2 minutes. Like, I'm a bit out of breath. Stamina-wise, I'm okay. Way better than I used to be. You know, in terms of stamina and how much breath I have, I feel like I'm okay. I can keep going. It's not a problem. But this is like the third day in a row that I've actually been doing some kind of training. And yeah, my knees and calves are quite sore. Tomorrow's a rest day, so I'm kind of looking forward to that. But you know, I totally started this at the right time of year. Sun's shining, it's warm, it's not too hot, but it's nice and warm. If I started this in 6 months' time, when it's starting to get cold and darker, yeah, I can see how that kind of put me off. Yeah, so at the moment I'm battling through the pain a bit, but overall I'm feeling good. Okay. I know I said that stamina-wise, I was fine. I'm now over 4K, and I'm really tired. Yeah, so that was one of the hardest ones I've had for a while. Maybe it's because this is the third day in a row. That probably might have an impact on how I feel right now. Alternatively, I mean, it's good, because if you're not pushing yourself, you're not actually gonna be doing anything worthwhile, so. Yeah, I made it, I did it, but it was hard. Like, my legs really tightened up towards the end, and they're quite sore, so I'm now running a bath. I'm going to do some stretches. Looking forward to not running tomorrow. I've got a meeting to go to now, so quick bath. I'm going to get some breakfast, going to have some fruit and yogurt.
Welcome to the Limehouse Marina. Lots of boats here. It's very peaceful, very quiet. And yeah, this morning is hard. I'm doing 1 kilometer running, 1 kilometer walking. It's the furthest I've ever done in like per stint running. And my legs were already stiff from yesterday and the day before. So yeah.
Wow, that was hard going. So, yeah, I did it, managed to do it, so I'm feeling quite a sense of achievement, but yeah, I'm going to be doing a lot of stretching. My body is a little bit broken right now. On the plus side, I did my fastest 5k and fastest 1k. I mean, the 1k kind of makes sense, because it's the first time I've run 1k solid without it being any walking intervals in between. Yeah, it was like 5 minutes and something, which is not gonna break any world records, but it's definitely going in the right direction. Looking forward to not running tomorrow, but I'll be doing a lot of stretching.
I thought I'd take a different route on today's run. Welcome to the A12. Yeah, it's a bit noisy, don't know if you can hear me.
Okay, just got back. So, different route, was hard. It was 1.6k run followed by 3.2k walk, which I thought that was going to be a lot easier than it really actually was. I suppose in the grand scheme of things, it was a mile run. Normally what I do with this interval stuff is I start with walking and then build up to running, and this was straight into running, so maybe there was a certain element of not being warmed up or not being stretched, so I put it down to that. But it's taken me most of the walk back to recover, but you know, I did it and I'm feeling good. I need lots of water and I'm going to need to do lots of stretching. Apparently, according to the app, it was my fastest mile ever, 9 minutes something, 3 times longer than the world record. But hey, feeling good and bad, but good.
Hi guys, welcome to Victoria Park. Saturday lunchtime-ish. Really, really tired right now. Today is 8K in total. It's like 2.4 or 2.6K run, followed by the same walking, followed by 1.6K running, and then the same walking. I'm quite tired. My knees and my calves, like at the top of my calves, it's quite sore. But I've been doing quite a bit of stretching. It's just the walk left now from my last alert on the app. So I thought I'd stop and talk to you guys, give an update. Here's the park. Do you know what? I love London. Like, people say, oh, like, people that don't live in London, London is just so busy and so noisy, and there's concrete everywhere. And I don't know, I think that's the tourist bits, but that's not noisy. I love it here. There's a lot more to London than the tourist bits. It's a lot greener than most people think. I'm gonna call that the end of week four. Today is day 27 in total. Tomorrow's a walking day, so I'm not gonna bother vlogging tomorrow. But yeah, that'll be the end of, that's the end of week four. And then on to week five. It's ramping up significantly now in terms of distance, both total distance running, and also the frequency of the runs versus the walks. Expect me to complain a lot more in the next few videos. Yeah, see you next week.